energy that is in stored form. Means the energy stored in food, the energy stored in fuels, the energy stored in firecrackers, the energy stored in cell and batteries is which energy? The chemical energy. Okay? Generally, the chemical energy converted into heat energy. Means when we consume food, when we eat food, what happens? The digestion of food takes place. When the digestion of food takes place, the chemical energy of food changes into heat energy. And after heat energy, it is transmitted through our body and we can do various activities. And now this heat energy converted into muscular energy. Suppose I am lifting this duster. By which energy? My muscular energy, my muscles energy. And how I get muscular energy? Due to the digestion of food. Okay. What happened, Mukund Singh?
Yes, sir.
What happened?
Sir, what is the difference between potential energy and kinetic energy?
Okay. That one I have discussed. Okay, I will tell you later. Okay. Yes, Sarina, what do you want to ask? Sarina Fatima.
Hello.
Sarina, tell me. Yes. Sarina Fatima. Okay. So, in these three cases, food, the chemical energy of food converted into heat energy, fuel, means the petrol, kerosene, CNG, LPG, all the things what the chemical energy of fuel converted into heat energy. And what happens in the case of firecrackers? The chemical energy of firecrackers converted into which energy? Heat energy and also sound energy. Because when we burst crackers, there is a release of heat energy also and sound energy also. Okay. And in the case of cell and batteries, what happened? The chemical energy of cell and batteries converted into electrical energy. Okay. Because the batteries of our inverter and the cell produce electricity. So the stored chemical energy of cell and batteries converted into electrical energy. Sarina Fatima, what do you want to ask? Okay, Astik Pratap, what do you want to ask? Tell me.
LPG.
I can't hear you properly. Tell me properly.
Sir, what is full form of LPG?
LPG, liquefied petroleum gas.
Okay.
Now, the question from Mukund Singh is difference between potential energy and kinetic energy. I have told you the difference between potential energy and kinetic energy. Both the energy is a form of mechanical energy. This is P dot E means potential energy and this is kinetic energy. The potential energy of any body is due to its position or due to its configuration of shapes. Suppose you put a ball from the ground level to some height. So which energy will be stored? Potential energy. And potential energy is the stored energy, is a form of stored energy. Or when we stretch a rubber, okay? When we stretch a rubber, so its shape change, configuration in shapes, so it is also potential energy. When we contract or expand the spring, what happens? There is a stored energy. And which energy is this? Potential energy. When we stretch a catapult, rubber of the catapult, what happens? Which energy is stored? The potential energy. And just we release the catapult, what happens? The stored potential energy changes into kinetic energy. Okay. And what is kinetic energy? The energy due to the motion of an object. Suppose there is a ball of some mass 2 kg. And it is moving. So which energy possesses this ball? Kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is due to the motion of an body and potential energy due to the shape, due to the position of body or shape or configuration of shapes. Okay. Now, the next is nuclear energy. I have discussed nuclear energy, but some students having doubt in nuclear energy. Nuclear energy is the energy that is stored in the nucleus of an atom. Okay. Atom uranium, plutonium. Okay. when the uranium splits into two nuclei, that is krypton and barium, what happens when it splits into two nuclei, two daughter nuclei? There is a release of energy, enormous amount of heat energy is released. Okay, and this energy is called nuclear energy. Okay, or some small nuclei, suppose hydrogen nuclei, hydrogen combined to form a single nuclei, a big nuclei. When two nuclei, means I told you, when two small nuclei combine to form a single nuclei, okay, what happens? There is an enormous amount of heat energy released, and this is called nuclear energy. So nuclear energy can be destructive and constructive as well as, okay. How it is destructive? Nuclear energy concept is used for making bombs, hydrogen bombs and atom bombs. And nuclear energy also used to produce electricity at power stations. Okay. Now we will understand interconversion of energy, means energy. There is a law of conservation of energy. Astik Pratap, what happened?
Nothing.
So lower your hand, Astik. Okay, Sarina Fatima, you have raised your hand from the beginning of the class, and when I ask you doubt, you don't respond. Why? Okay, we will study the law of conservation of energy. So whoever knows the law of conservation of energy, please raise your hand. Law of conservation of energy, anybody knows what is law of conservation of energy? Yes, anyone? Okay, no one knows. Okay, Astik. Okay, tell me, Astik.
Nandi, that neither be created, neither be destroyed, called law of energy.
Okay. Ragini Singh.
Sir, it states that energy is neither created nor destroyed in a system, and the sum of total of energy remains the same. It can only be transformed from one form to another.
Very good. Yes. So, law of conservation of energy says that energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Only a form of energy is changed. Means one form of energy is converted into another form. So we will study the interconversion of energy. That means the change of one form of energy to the another form of energy. The first is mechanical energy into light, into heat, light and sound energy. Okay. When we rub our hands, what happens? The mechanical energy change into which energy? When we rub our hands in winter, what happens? Our hand is doing mechanical energy. Okay, so which energy is produced on rubbing the hand? Who will tell? Which energy is released? Okay, Astik. Okay, Nazreen Fatima, you tell.
Energy.
Okay, very good. So when we rub our hands, so the mechanical energy of our hand is converted into heat energy, because in winters, when we feel cold, what do? We rub our hands to produce heat. So after rubbing, what happens? Our hand gets heated. So mechanical energy converted into heat energy. Okay. What happens when two stones strike? When two stones strike each other, what happens? The mechanical energy of the stones change into heat energy, because when two stones strike, what happens? There is a sparkling of heat and also the sound will come. So the mechanical energy converted into heat energy and sound energy. Mukund Singh, yes.
So in last question, I have raised my hand and forgot to lower my hand.
Okay, no problem. Okay. If a grinder is moving, suppose a grinder is moving. What, and when we place something like knife, okay, when something is moving, a motor is moving, when we place knife, what happens? It will collide. The knife and the grinder will collide, and what happens? The heat will release, the light energy will release, and sound will release. So it is about the mechanical energy converted into heat energy, light energy, and sound energy. Okay, the mechanical energy into potential energy and kinetic energy. We all have seen the toy car which operate on key. Okay, key car. Okay, and there is a key like this. There is a key which we rotate the car and the car moves. What happens inside the car? There is a strip. When we rotate the key, what happens? The strip wind over the motor of the car, toy car. Okay, so the mechanical energy, when we rotate the key, our hand is doing mechanical energy, and the mechanical energy is converted into potential energy because the wind gets wind over one. Okay, so after releasing the key, what happens? It unwinds, means it opens. When it opens, what happens? The toy car moves. So here mechanical energy is converted into potential energy, and the potential energy converted into kinetic energy. Okay, the potential energy of water in hydel dams into electrical energy. See here. There is a dam. Okay, and water is stored here. So at some height, when water falls here, which energy is stored? The potential energy. Okay, potential energy is stored at this height. When water is released, what happens? The potential energy is changed into kinetic energy. And in a hydroelectrical plant, what happens when water is released, means what? Water is about to fall. It falls on a turbine. Okay, there is a turbine here. When water falls on a turbine, the turbine rotates. Okay, the turbine rotates. So the potential energy of water changes into kinetic energy. Okay, after the turbine moves, and when the turbine moves, there is a release of electricity. It is connected to a wire, and this wire produces electricity. Means the first potential energy converted into the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy converted into again mechanical energy, because turbine moves, the mechanical energy is produced, and then electrical energy. Okay, chemical energy into light energy, that I have told you. The in the case of firecrackers, what happens when you burst the firecrackers? The stored chemical energy converted into light energy, heat energy, and sound energy. Electrical energy into heat energy. The electrical geyser operates on electricity. So what happens when we on the geyser, switch on the geyser, the electricity or the electrical energy converted into heat energy. When we on the microwave, toaster, okay, what happens? The electrical energy converted into heat energy. So next is heat energy into electrical energy. It is happens in thermal station, power thermal station. What happens? Thermal station, see here. In thermal station, we heat the water. Okay, suppose there is a water, and what we do, we put a burner here, and the burner produces heat energy. The water gets heated. After water gets heated, the water change into steam, and the steam runs the turbine. The steam means the gas runs the turbine, and after running of turbine, the electricity is produced. So heat energy is converted into electrical energy. Now, electrical energy into magnetic energy. I have explained you the concept of electromagnet, and I know you all have, means most of the students have tried to make the electromagnet with the help of needle. The needle we have to wind a wire, connect to a electricity, means battery. So what happens when you switch on the battery, this needle will behave as a magnet. So here the electrical energy is converted into magnetic energy, and this is called electromagnet. Now, electrical energy into light energy, very simple. The LED, CFL, and our electric bulbs, what happens? The electrical energy converted into light energy. So the electrical, due to electric bulb, convert the electrical energy to light energy and produce light. Light energy into electrical energy. There are some photovoltaic cells. Who heard about solar cells? Solar cell? Who have seen the solar cell? Raise your hand. Okay. Asik Pratap. Solar cell. Okay, Asik, give me idea about solar cell. What do you understand about solar cells?
Solar cell convert light energy into electric energy.
Which light energy?
Sir, sun.
Okay, very good. So, sir, yes, what do you want to say?
Sir, it is used in the lighter.
Okay. Lighter?
Yes.
Which lighter?
Sir, emergency lighter.
Yes, emergency light. Okay. I think the lighter you are saying. Okay. Avigyan. What do you understand about solar cell?
Sir, it is a cell used to take the sunlight and give us light energy.
Okay.
To use at home and emergency light.
Okay. Navya Agrawal, tell me, what do you understand about solar cells? What is the idea? Anything else?
Sir, it converts heat energy into light energy.
Heat energy?
Sir, it converts heat into light energy.
Okay. So, most of the students answered correctly. Solar cells. You have seen a solar plant, solar device like this. There is a cell placed in this solar panel, like a button shape, this shape. Okay, solar panel. Like this. And it is the photovoltaic cell. What it does, it receives the light from the sun. Light from the sun. And this photovoltaic cell converts the light energy of the sun to the electrical energy. So it is the example of interconversion of light energy into electrical energy. Okay. Okay, sound energy into electrical energy. Very easy example. When I speak, okay, what happens? The mic receives my sound. Okay, and the mic operates on electricity. So the sound energy is converted into electrical energy, the electric signal, and you hear at your home. So my sound is converted into electrical energy, and then this signal transmits, and you can hear again sound energy at your home. Okay, now electrical energy into sound energy. The sound box, the woofer, the home theaters, all runs on electricity and it produces sounds. Chemical energy into mechanical energy. Okay. The vehicles which runs on a petrol, diesel, what happens? The stored chemical energy of these fuels converted into heat energy. Then it converted into mechanical energy. Suppose there is a car. Okay. It runs on a fuel. Fuel have chemical energy. When we fill the fuel in this car, what happens? The car moves when we start the engine. So the chemical energy converted into mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is that energy due to which a body moves. Okay. Electrical energy into chemical energy. Yes, very easy example. The inverter batteries. What happens? When inverter batteries discharge, means the battery gets over, down. We charge the battery with the help of electricity. What happens when we charge the battery? The electrical energy converted into the chemical energy, and the battery stored the energy in the form of chemical energy. So the electrical energy changed into chemical energy. Now, light energy into chemical energy. Light energy into chemical energy. Can you give me example, the light energy into chemical energy? Yes, Faisal. Yes.
During photosynthesis, the light energy changes into chemical energy.
Okay, very good.
Thank you, sir.
So, light energy into chemical energy. Suppose this is a plant. Okay, how plants make food with the help of photosynthesis? It receives light energy of the sun and it prepares food. And which energy is stored in a food? Chemical energy. So light energy is converted into chemical energy. Okay. Now we will discuss exercise and I will ask a question and you have to answer me. And the rest of the things we will discuss in next class. Okay, tell me, during digestion of food, the chemical energy of food changes into which energy? Ishika Raj. Yes.
Sir, heat energy.
Heat energy. Okay. Ishika, you tell me, in hydroelectric. Good morning. In hydroelectric dams, the kinetic energy of flowing water is transformed into
electric energy.
Very good. Okay. Okay, who will define what is kinetic energy? Ankita Mishra.
Yes, sir. Sir, what is the question? Repeat,
what,
please.
What is kinetic energy?
Sir, what is
kinetic?
The energy processed by a body by virtue of its motion is called kinetic energy.
Okay, very good.
Thank you.
Okay, students. It is not in your class, but I am telling you the formula of kinetic energy and potential energy. The formula of potential energy is mgh. M is the mass of an that object. H is the height where you place the object from the ground level. Height. And g is the acceleration due to gravity. And value of g is we will take 10 meter per second square. Okay. And when you solve the numerical, put the value of mass in kilogram and value of height in meter. Okay, I'm giving you a numerical. We have to calculate potential energy. Mass is 20 kg. Height is 5 meter. You have to calculate potential energy. Okay, who will solve? Mass is 50 kg, height is 5 meter. Ragini Singh. Okay, she lowered hand. Vaibhav. Okay, tell me, Vaibhav. Vaibhav. Okay, Ankita, you tell. Ankita Mishra.
Sir, it will be 5.
No, I am asking, what is the potential energy? Mass is 20 kg.
Yes, sir.
Height is 5 meter and G is always 10. So what will be the value?
Sir, it will be 14.
40, no. See here.
Okay, sir.
See here. Mass is 20 kg. G is 10. And height is 5. So we have to multiply this 20 into 10, 200 into 5, 1000. Okay, who will tell me the SI unit of energy? SI unit of energy. Harshika Agarwal. Yes, tell me.
Sir, joule.
Joule. And what is the SI unit of potential energy?
Sir,
MGH. No, SI unit of potential energy is also joule. SI unit of every form of energy will be joule. Okay?
Okay, sir.
See, SI unit of energy is joule. If you have asked what is SI unit of potential energy, it will be the same, joule, because it is a form of energy. So SI unit of potential energy, kinetic energy will be joule. So it will be 1000 joule. Yes, on that day, I am discussing about the roller coaster. Okay, roller coaster. It is like this. okay? What happens? There is a car. It starts moving, and suppose it reaches here. Then it will goes downward, then here, then here, then here. So I have told you, Vaibhav, what happened, Vaibhav, what happened?
Sir, nothing.
Okay. Okay, I'm telling you, the energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Okay, energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Only the form of energy change. Means we have discussed the interchange of the forms of energy. So in the roller coaster, suppose the car is here. So tell me about potential energy and kinetic energy. It is start moving and it's here. So tell me which is maximum. Potential energy is maximum here or kinetic energy is maximum? It is moving. Who will tell me? What is the maximum here? Potential energy or kinetic energy? Astik Pratap.
Sir, potential energy.
Okay. Vaibhav, you tell me.
Sir, kinetic energy.
Ankita, you tell me.
Sir, kinetic energy.
Okay, very good. So the answer will be here, kinetic energy will be the maximum. Okay, and potential energy will be the minimum. And it will be zero because this car is at ground level. It has no height with the ground level. This is the ground level and the car is at ground level. So there is no height it is attained. So the H is equals to zero. So potential energy will be minimum. When car starts moving and reaches at the highest point here. Now it stops. It stops and for a few moment. Here at the highest point, the car stops for a few moment. So tell me about potential energy and kinetic energy. Which will be maximum and which will be the minimum? So who will tell me? Harshika Agarwal. You tell.
Sir, please tell the question one more time.
I'm asking, at this height, when car starts moving from the ground level, from the initial point, it reaches to a highest point, this peak point. So it stops for a moment before going downwards. So tell me, which will be the maximum, kinetic energy or potential energy?
So potential energy.
Okay. And what about kinetic energy? Okay. Okay. I'm asking to Shaurya Singh.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Shaurya.
Sir, potential energy maximum.
Okay. See here, I have told you for a moment the car stops. When the car stops, its velocity will be zero. So there is no velocity. So there will be kinetic energy will be the zero, means minimum. And it attains at a maximum height. See here, it is a peak point. So here, potential energy will be the maximum. Okay. So it happens in a roller coaster. What happens when we give the velocity to this car? Car starts moving and it reaches through the highest point. Means now the kinetic energy is converted into potential energy. Means here, kinetic changes into potential energy. When car reaches to the highest point, what happens? The potential energy is maximum, means the whole kinetic energy change into potential energy. Now after that, the car starts moving downwards. What will happen? All the potential energy will change into which energy? Who will tell? Tanmay Chaubey. What will happen,
sir,
here?
Sir, kinetic energy.
Yes, here what will happen?
Sir, kinetic energy.
Okay, Ankita Mishra, you tell me.
Sir, kinetic energy.
No, I'm not asking kinetic energy. What will happen? Which energy will convert into which energy after moving downwards? Which energy will convert into which energy?
Sir.
See, all of you, yes. Listen carefully. Here, potential energy is the maximum. And when car starts moving, the potential energy will convert into kinetic energy. okay? Because here is the stored potential energy and the maximum potential energy. When car moving downward, all the potential energy will change into kinetic energy. And here, the potential energy becomes zero because it is the lowest point, and kinetic energy becomes maximum. Okay? So tell me about this point. Suppose this is A, B, C, about C point. Okay, I will ask you randomly. Ragini Singh.
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell me, Ragini, about this point. What is the, what will be kinetic energy and what is the potential energy? Maximum, minimum?
Sir, the potential energy increases.
Yes,
and
very good.
Becomes energy one due to gain in height, while the kinetic energy decreases.
Wow, very good. Okay.
Thank you,
I want one more student to answer it. Okay, Bhavika Dubey, 7th A. What is your answer?
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Sir, potential energy will be maximum and kinetic energy will be minimum.
Okay, very good. Who answered just now before Bhavya? Please raise your hand. Who answered me? Bhavika, I forget his her name. Bhavika Tanmay. Bhavika, who answered before you? Okay, the one who answered me just before, Bhavika. Okay, Ankita, what is your answer? Yes, Ragini Singh. Yes, Ragini Singh. Yes, Ankita, what is your answer?
Sir, kinetic energy is minimum. So, no, sir, maximum, and potential energy is minimum.
Okay, okay. So, you all three have answered me correctly, but the girl, Ragini, has answered, means explained very well. Means when the car moves to the height, what happens? Here, kinetic energy change into the potential energy. Why? Because it is attaining height and kinetic energy will decrease. At this point, potential energy will be the maximum. And for a moment, the car stops, the kinetic energy becomes zero, means minimum. And after this, the same process will repeat here all, as it is here from this point to this point. Okay, from A to B. So this is about interconversion of state kinetic energy to potential energy and potential to kinetic energy in a roller coaster. Okay. So, overall that the energy is stored. The energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Only the forms of energy is changing. Kinetic to potential, potential to kinetic, and kinetic to potential. Okay. And one thing more I want to ask. Please lower your hand, all of you. Lower your hand. If this will happen continuous or it will stop? If we release the car from here, means it will reach here, then it will goes upwards due to the change in energy, or it will be stops after some time? Who will tell me? It will stops after some time. Who will tell? Yes, Ankita Mishra. Yes, Ankita Mishra.
Sir, it will be stopped.
Okay. Okay, Harshika Agrawal. It will be stopped after some time. Tell me.
Yes, sir, it will stop after some time.
When, why it will stop? Due to which thing? Which
because
factor?
Because heat of the line.
Sorry? Please repeat.
Sir, it will stop after some time.
Okay. Okay, Ragini Singh, you tell me.
Due to which factors? Sir, what is the question?
Due to which factors the car will stop?
Sir, don't know.
Okay. So it will stop after some time. Why it is? Due to the friction of road. Because there is a friction. So always there is a loss of energy due to the friction. Here is this friction. And due to the air resistance, due to the gravitation, there is always loss of energy. Suppose initially the energy is 100 joule here. Potential is 100 joule. So the whole energy will not convert into kinetic energy because there will be the loss of energy. When the car moves, there is a due to the friction and air resistance, there will be loss of energy. Means there is a 100 joule here initially at first, and when it converted into kinetic energy, it will be not 100, it will be 90 joule or something less. Now, if we again 90 joule convert this converted into potential energy, not whole 90 joule, it will be 80 joule. Means there will be a continuous loss of energy due to the friction, due to the air resistance, due to the gravity. So after some time, the car will stop. Okay. And the same thing happened in simple pendulum. Okay. What happens in simple pendulum? When we apply force, the ball moves here. And it again, first it moves from A to B, then B to A, then A to C. Okay. A to B, B to A, B to A, then A to C, then again C to A. And after some time, this pendulum stops. And why it stops? Due to the air friction. Okay. Due to the air friction, air resistance, and the gravitational force. Okay. So it is all about today. If you have any doubt, you may ask in next class. Okay. So thank you, everyone. Okay. What happened, Navya Agrawal? You raise your hand. Vaibho, any doubt? Okay, Sachin, okay, you don't have any doubt. Okay, thank you, everyone.